If you've ever attended a ballet performance, you know it can be a powerful experience. But what if the dance somehow inspired us to engage more with our neighbors? That's part of the mission behind Ballet 5-8. Juliana Slager, who is the artistic director, and dancer Beth Patterson are here with us. We're so glad to have you both.
Thank you for having us,
Heather. So, Ballet 5-8, what is it? What's it all about?
Yeah, Ballet 5-8 was founded in 2012 by myself and my co-founder, Amy Sanderson. And we started the ballet company because we wanted to share ballets that would spark discussion of life and faith with the audience.
Wow, and I was reading you started with 12, and now you have over 300 students.
Yes.
That's great.
Yeah, thank you. Yeah, we have 300 students in our School of the Arts, and Beth, along with 12 other dancers, are in our professional company, and we tour nationally.
So you're kind of based out of the Chicago area.
Yes.
So when you mentioned you travel, you've actually made the trip here to Urbana because you have a performance coming up. So Beth, why don't you tell me a little bit about what people can experience at your event?
I would say accessibility. Anyone can come to see and take anything out of what they see. There's a piece called Shades of Refrain, and it's based on verses of Psalms, and it's a very like worshipful piece that we have that's based on community and just overall sense of redemption. It's like a beautiful piece that you can.
Oh, well, yeah, because I know ballet can be so powerful when you're watching it, and that's what you want people to be able to take away is some kind of experience. Mm-hmm. So why did you feel that was important when you created this this dance company?
Yeah, well, ballet is beautiful, and there's certainly a side of it where it's lovely to watch just how athletic the dancers are and how graceful and agile they are. But I think on top of that, when you come to see a performance, you want to leave feeling uplifted and feeling connected to more than just the athleticism of the piece. And so what we do at Ballet 5-8 is we tell stories that are relevant. Like Beth was saying, they're very accessible. You can come to the ballet and you don't have to know anything about classical ballet to enjoy it, especially Compass. Compass is based on current world topics. So if you've watched the news in the last 10 years, Compass is the ballet for you.
Right. So Compass is the program.
Yes.
That's coming this Saturday. And it's going to have 5 one-act ballets.
Yes.
So are they like separated and like a whole new crew of dancers come out, or how does it work?
Well, we're a small company, so everyone does everything really, and so it's pretty exhausting, but very fulfilling, you know.
What do you enjoy most about ballet and being with this program?
I would say the camaraderie of it, and everyone's working towards the same goal, and that's very uplifting and inspiring to see that everyone's on the same track and the same mindset, and it moves towards our purpose even more because of that.
Yeah, so this first premiered last season, and so now we're kind of bringing it back for the spring, right?
Yeah.
And I was reading here that your work is called 4501?
Yeah.
Is that right?
Yes.
Okay, so tell me a little bit about this because this is interesting. Maybe he got into a few too many Girl Scout cookies.
No? Yeah. No, that's such a great question. So the new ballet we're premiering this weekend is based on the prison system. And it's kind of taking a look and saying, can we see redemption? Is there a way that people, even in the darkest corners of our nation, is there a way that they can still be touched and redeemed? And I think it's a question that's worth asking. Are these people still worthy of redemption? Do we as a society believe that they're still able to come back from the brink? Even people that we might think of as totally different from ourselves. But I think it teaches us something about how we can all be redeemed no matter what we've done or how bad we might think we are, that there's always hope for each and every human.
Yeah, and you're gonna be portraying that via ballet in this performance. So it's happening this weekend in Urbana. Tell me a little bit about the logistics, when and where.
Yeah, so we're at Urbana High School. We're in their theater. It's gonna be 7 o'clock on Saturday evening.
Okay, and tickets are very reasonably priced for a ballet.
Yes.
$25 for adults and $20 for seniors over 65, as well as college students. We wish you the best of luck. Welcome to Central Illinois.
Thank you.
Have a great ballet. For more information on the event, head to our Facebook page. We've got it posted for you there. All right, here's Tim.